Hi guys, I'm Jordan. Welcome to our first video on art and music over 50 years. This is going to span the time from 1900 to 1950. And today we're going to start in all the way back to 1900, and we're going to start in the birth of jazz. Now, jazz was an origin kind of coming from this much older genre called ragtime. Now, ragtime was known a lot for its heavy piano melodies and a lot of very active and joyous singing. Now, ragtime comes from African-American communities, and more specifically, it comes from a lot of African-styled stuttered and rhythmic beats from a very, very long time ago. So ragtime itself has been kind of modified since then of the march style that was kind of made famous by John Philip Sousa. I'm sure that you guys have heard of, you know, Sousa before, maybe through the sousaphone, or more commonly known as the tuba, you know, the big guy. And the additional rhythms kind of really coming from that African background. Now, ragtime composer Scott Joplin became famous through the creation of the Maple Leaf Rag, and a number of hits like The Entertainer, and he was really forgotten by a lot of aficionados until a while ago. One more famous song from the time, Rusty Rags, I'm going to have playing behind me right now to give everybody kind of a reference up to what this might sound like. It's very different from today's popular music, although you might have heard something like this in perhaps older movies or older cinema and TV. It's not really as common today, and so I'm going to kind of quiet myself and let the music take over as you can enjoy this quick little snippet. Now, I think we all realize that jazz just didn't exist in, well, the 1900s. I'm sure we've heard versions of jazz today. And that's very true. We've had people come about, such as Ella Fitzgerald and Louis Armstrong and Miles Davis and John Coltrane, which have really taken jazz in all of these incredibly different directions in terms of really bombastic, really really moving sounds. I'm sure swing has come to mind. That's a style of jazz that really took the rhythms and took the melodies that were especially energetic, and they just ran with it, and a lot of energy came from there. As well as Whitey's Lindy Hoppers, those were people who came up with this very active dance of grabbing people and throwing them over their shoulder and bringing them back over and just tossing them around and throwing them around. And it was a really active, and it was a really crazy dance for the time, you know, really active and really energetic. And so it hadn't really been seen before. So I'm going to show you guys a short clip of that right here. And just to give everybody an idea of the style that was becoming very popular at the time.
Oh man, don't stop now, we're jumping. Give everything the law now. This thing might turn into something. I ain't mistaken, here comes something now.
So the last example I'm going to show in this video today is Chuck Berry's The Twist. Now, this has had sequels to it, and this has had iterations to it. Because of its popularity, this was one of the biggest dances to be shown on network television at the time. They had him kind of come out and show this dance off to the nation, and that's what really caught the eye of a lot of Americans everywhere, African-American or white, or whoever. Everybody was very much getting in on this, well, musical trend, and a lot of people were really, really enjoying themselves. So this was one of the first instances, I would say, of widespread expressionism with large groups of people. Dances were common between two partners, whether that be ballroom dances or maybe even line dances, but to have everybody on the floor dancing this particular way, it wasn't something that was very common until the jazz era. So I'm going to play that for everybody here today, and then after that's played, we're going to move on to our project for this lesson.
Called the twist. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Chubby Checker.
So dance has been around for as long as humans have been around. So I'm sure that everybody has seen their own versions of dances today, whether that be the Millie Rock, whether that be the Whip and the Nene. That was a few years ago. More commonly, a lot of dances have shown up on very popular streaming platform TikTok, where this culture of sharing your expression has really taken off. So I think it's safe to say that everybody watching this video will have their own experiences with dance. So our project for today is going to be to look at different jazz dances and songs and create your own jazz style dance to teach your friends and family. So I think that especially right now, it's good to have something to kind of express yourself and feel some joy in and teach to others that you may be around right now. So for what you're going to need, it's really, really simple. We're going to need something that accesses the internet and something that you can write on, so like pencils and paper. So the first thing we're going to do, all right, we're going to look online for different jazz dances like the twist and the Lindy Hop, which we talked about and we saw here today. And I'm going to have those linked in the lesson plan as well that you can find on ASI. We're also going to have, we're going to have ourselves think about those dance moves in jazz. You know, how do they move their feet? How do they move their arms? Do they shuffle? Do they kind of like scoot around? No, they're out. You know, they're exciting. So how do you find a way to involve those types of arm and leg movements and feet movements into the dance that you're going to create? You know, they're very, very active. Traditional jazz dances are incredibly active and boisterous. So don't be afraid to get moving. Don't be afraid to really get yourself out there. Step three, you're going to write your moves down on some paper so you can teach your friends and family so they can join in the fun too. Now, this doesn't have to be restricted to, you know, step one, move your foot in this position. No, you can draw diagrams if you want to. You can draw feet movements. You could even do a step-by-step guide as to how to move your arms. It's really up to you and how you think you should teach others. Now, for the way to kind of expand this to like a group setting, show off these, you know, swinging moves to your family and friends. The more dancers, the merrier, you know? Expression is something that we all need and that we all use in our daily lives. So having a way to share that with somebody is always exciting and it's always enjoyable. So to kind of extend this, dancing is really everywhere around us. So feel free to look on YouTube for other dances and songs to keep moving to. Going back to TikTok, TikTok is a great example of almost every trend that's out now. It's a new dance, it's a new song. It's something to express yourself and kind of alternate. You know, you see a dance anywhere, you don't have to keep it the way that it was made. Improvise, you know, elaborate. If it wasn't for improvisation and building upon something else, then we wouldn't have the music that we have today. There would be no country, no rock and roll, no hip hop, no rap, no anything. It all comes from, ragtime and jazz and those areas. That's where a lot of rock and hip hop comes from today. So be sure to just kind of look online for anything that you can think of. Now, our vocabulary for this week is going to be ragtime, rhythm, swing, and icon. You can find those in the book's glossary section for reference. And that is going to conclude our lesson today. I hope everybody had a great time. Both the videos are going to be linked in the bottom of the blog post, and there's also going to be further resources that you can find online for this. I hope everybody had a great time, and I will see you in the next one.